let me discuss about thermal power plant. This is the layout of the thermal power plant where we will see clearly. Thermal power plant. Right? So from the name itself you can see it's a thermal, nothing but by the combustion, by heating the coal, by the combustion of coal, a high temperature of heat is produced. Now we are utilizing this heat to convert water into steam. Once after boiling the water with this temperature, above the boiling point, the water will be converted to steam with high pressure. So this steam is given across the turbine blades where the turbine is getting the steam energy will be converted into mechanical energy. Once this mechanical energy, this is connected across the alternator where this mechanical energy is going to convert it into electrical energy. First, let me see each and every block in detail. See here, first it starts from coal storage plant. So first, if you see the thermal power plant location, how do we select the location? It should be in prime location where the coal is available, or at least where you can transport easily. Nothing but the road transport and rail transport should be feasible. And the land cost should be low in such a way that in further years, if we want to extend the substation, it should be capable to withstand. Nothing but you can extend the substation. And if the land, it should be in such a way that it can withstand for heavy equipment. Because whatever the equipment we are using are of high inertia, so the land should be capable for holding that heavy weight. So in such a way that you have to select the location for placing the thermal power plant. So compared to other power plants, the installation cost is less in the thermal power plant. The main drawbacks, if you talk, you will get it is not neat. You will get flue gases which is sent out to the chimney, and the running cost will be added here because for coal we have to buy and have to store it. Hence, it costs for but source which we are using here, and the plant which you are placing should be near to some river or at least some lake. Some water source should be near to your thermal power plant. Right. So now let me see in detail about each and every block of your thermal power plant. If you see, first is the coal storage plant. What is the task of the coal storage plant? First we will store the coal, because if there is any spikes, it should not be spare of coal that the thermal power plant should not go in a shutdown mode because of the scarcity of the coal. So first itself you have to store the coal. From this coal storage plant, the coal is pumped to the coal handling plant. Here the coal is pulverized into small minute particles. Even if you can see clearly our powder particles. Whatever the powder we will use, talcum powder, even one part of every part of a powder, how much fine particle it will be. That much fine particle that will pulverize the coal. Because if you see a coal which is of large space, the surface area of a big piece and the surface area of a small piece will be moved. If this is chopped into many number of small particles, the exposure of the surface area to the heat will be more. That is the reason where you can produce more heat. That is the reason we are pulverizing the coal particles, big particles into small minute particles. Now these coal particles are pumped over your boiler. So what is the boiler? It consists of a furnace, big furnace, where the water is pumped through the economizer. First in the boiler where you are pumping the coal, here the coal is getting combustion and a very high degree temperature we are going to produce here. So in this furnace, in the boiler, there will be high temperature. In this boiler furnace, we are pumping the water through the tubes. Okay, so this where do the water comes? You can see here where do the water is coming. You can see there is a water, a river. From the river there is a water treatment plant. So because you have to filter out the dust particles over the river which are present in the river. So all the dust particles are removed and treated. Then the water is fed to the feed water. Then it is getting to the economizer. If you see here, what does the economizer does? Here there are the main three blocks per meter, and from the economizer to the air heater there is a common link. What is this common link? This common link is due to flue gases. Because after combustion of coal, you will get different number of flue gases which you have to exert into the atmosphere, which is not necessary. But the flue gases will consist of high temperature. I have to utilize the heat of this flue gases. So what I am going to do, in every stage of the flue gases going to the atmosphere, in every stage I am utilizing the heat of the flue gases. Then after we will send it to the through the chimney to the atmosphere. Right? So, and we will get flue gases after combustion and we will get ash. So this ash has to be removed periodically. So if ash deposits are, if you are not removing properly, this reduces the boiler efficiency. This boiler will not work properly because of deposits of ash. So regularly you have to remove out the ashes out with the ash handling and then goes to ash storage. So next, so these flue gases are fed to super meter, economizer, air heater. Now let me see each and every block functioning. So all these three blocks are very important with concern with the boiler. Why? It increases the boiler efficiency. Means the boiler working, we are reducing the stress of the boiler. How? By providing a proper atmosphere in the boiler. So if I want to get high temperature heat, what we have to do? First we have to, the air around the boiler should be heated. It should not be cooled. If the air is heated under that combustion of coal, if you are maintaining hot air, now the temperature around the boiler will be more, right? Means you are increasing the efficiency. So how you are producing the air and everything you will see here. So now the surrounding atmospheric air in the boiler is fed to the air preheater. What is the task of an air preheater? You can see there is a forced draft fan. There is a draft fan which sucks the air from the atmosphere and it get dragged towards your air preheater. If what happens in this air preheater is a closed chamber where it is filled with hot air. What is that hot air? That hot air is due to flue gases. Now this air preheater chamber is full of hot air due to the flue gases. Now in this we are going to pump the air. In this you can pump the air in two types. Jet condenser, air preheater also two types with the help of tubes. You can send the air through the tubes. So it is full of hot air. If the air inside the tubes is heated up, then that air is passed to the boiler. Means the boiler temperature you are maintaining more by sending hot air to the boiler through air preheater. There is another way. Nothing but an air preheater, you will have a fan type of construction, a drum connected with the wings. So one side the air, flue gases will strike the one side of the drum. The other side, the force draft fan will suck the air on the other side. So in this way, the two airs, the hot air and the natural atmosphere air will get mixed up with each other with this fan. Then it is pumped out to the boiler. This is the second type of construction which is generally used in the air preheater, where the hot air is pumped out to the boiler. Next, let me see the working of an economizer. What is the task of an economizer? If you see the economizer, the water is fed through the economizer. See, from the river, the water is treated, then it is gone to the water, feed water pump, then it is went to the economizer. If you see, the river water will be in cool temperature, it is not hot water. But if you want to convert the water into steam, cool water converting steam will take more time, and the hot water converting into steam will take more time. Obviously, the hot water converting to steam is more easy than the normal air converting into steam. So, means nothing but you are reducing the stress in the boiler by increasing the efficiency of the boiler. So, what I am going to do? This normal water is pumped to the economizer through the tubes. Through the tubes. So, what here also two types you will have. Through the tubes, water is pumped. And through the tubes, the flue gas products are pumped. The water is circulated over the economizer. Two ways we have. Here you will have a parallel tubes. In the tubes, the water is pumped, the total chamber is filled with water. And the tubes consist of flue gases, where the economizer chamber consists of water. Means steam which I have produced in the boiler. Now whatever the water which is boiled above the boiling point in the boiler will convert into steam. That steam is pumped out through the tubes to the superheater. What happens in superheater? The steam goes beyond its boiling point, where the pressure of the steam increases more, then it is given to the turbine. Right? So we are increasing the pressure of the steam from the boiler with the help of superheater, then it is given to your turbine blades. Now if you talk about the turbine blades, take out the turbine blades are of two categories: reaction type of turbine and impulsion type of turbines. So if you talk about impulse turbine, before talking about the construction, let me complete the total working. So here this is pressure of the steam is given across the turbine blades, hence this turbine starts rotating. One keep in mind that just pumping the steam across the turbine blades, we will not get mechanical energy. How do we get the mechanical energy? There should be a temperature difference across the turbine blades. Especially here, getting the steam energy which is converting into kinetic energy or mechanical energy is due to Rankine cycle. Keep in mind that it is due to Rankine cycle. This is the basic principle for the production of converting into thermal energy, nothing but steam energy into mechanical energy. What we are doing over one side, it is pumped over one side, the temperature should be high. The other side of the blade, the temperature should be low. Due to the high temperature difference, the mechanical energy will be more. If the temperature difference is less, the mechanical energy will be less for us. Hence, the other side of the blade, to maintain less temperature, you are having a component called as condenser. Here, the condenser is a device where the exhausted steam over the other side of the blade is getting cooled by mixing with cool water. There is a cooling tower you will have, where the cooling water is pumped over the condenser. So through the condenser, the exhausted steam, that is the other side of the blade of the steam, is getting cooled by the help of condenser. Now you can ask, what is the efficiency of total thermal power plant? Normal efficiency of a thermal power plant is 29% only. If it is modernized, it is going up to 35%. The efficiency of thermal power plant is very low. Why? Because here, whatever the heat we have produced by large constraints, we are producing the heat. Assume that I have produced 15,000 kilocalories of heat by combustion of coal. 15,000. But coming here, I am not even getting 300. There is only 29% of heat can be utilized in here to getting mechanical energy. Why? The main loss is occurring due to condenser. Whatever the heat you are producing, but here what I have to do to get more mechanical energy, I have to reduce the temperature. Here we only generating the heat, here we only reducing the temperature. Why you have to reduce the temperature? If not, it will not get more mechanical energy. So based on the Rankine cycle, you have to reduce the temperature of the other side of the blade with the help of condenser. Hence, the maximum, if it is 30% is the total energy you are getting to get mechanical energy. This mechanical energy is given to the alternator. Only 1% of loss will be across the electrical energy. Remaining 29% is losses. Sorry, remaining 70%. If you take 70%, 69% of losses is due to in the maximum thermal plant. In that 69%, majority losses are occurs due to condenser. Here condensers are also two types. One is jet type condenser, second one is surface condenser. Jet type condenser is nothing but it is a simple construction where cool water is mixed with the steam. Here you will have a chamber where exhaust steam is fed over this chamber. In this chamber, on the downside, we are ejecting cool water. Cool water will get mixed with steam, then the temperature we are going to reduce over the other side. So we will maintain this down part of the turbine as low as possible with respect to the jet condenser. This construction is very less, but main drawback is we are not making the steam into water separate because you are mixing up. So hence the temperature is getting reduced, but you are not segregating the water from the steam separately. main three components which increases the efficiency of the boiler. Coming to the condenser, this is the main part where the majority of loss will occur. Right? If you go for turbines, I said the steam turbines are two types, which are impulse turbine and reaction turbine. If you see the two construction little bit, it will be similar. But coming to the impulsion turbine, you will have a fixed nozzle and to the shaft you will have a rotating blades. So over the nozzle the force of steam is pumped. So the pressure of what happened through the nozzle, it will expand the steam by reducing the pressure. So while expanding, the steam is expanded over the blades, the moving blades will start rotating. Because the other side, while expanding, the other side temperature automatically is cooled because of the condenser. In this way it starts rotating. In impulse turbine, reaction turbine, what happens is, with respect to the fixed blades, I said through the nozzle you are getting, the blades will not reduce the pressure, only nozzle will